Wontonmeen.
Hi everyone, welcome to another tiny Galaxy concert here in Wontonmeen in Sham Shui Po in Hong Kong. Series the Hong Kong Sinfonietta is putting together, putting on in this fabulous little space here in a very local and great, mixed, eclectic part of the city. Because of the space, obviously everything's quite small and intimate, and today we've got two works for you, but it all focuses on Roger Smalley, who was an Australian composer who sadly died about 5 years ago. And I was lucky to know Roger very, very well, both musically and personally. And it begins at the end of the concert. I'll be playing a duo for two violins, which I premiered more than 10 years ago now. But to begin with, a work I wrote just last year. I was even kind of putting final touches on it just a few weeks ago, because it was due to be performed in Sydney, but obviously because of the pandemic situation, everything in Sydney as well has been put on hold for a while, concerts and halls and so on. So the world premiere has had to wait, and this work is four studies for a portrait of Roger Smalley. A very Francis Bacon-like title. I had this idea, it's actually a very large work, almost 25 minutes in four movements, which can be played in isolation or together as one huge work. I had this idea to put, I suppose, to make a portrait and sound of various aspects of Roger, which I admire and respect and got to know so well. This is the third of these studies, and it comes after a couple of very, very difficult movements. And this is actually called For the Five Fingers. And any of you pianists out there will know there's a long history. Even the first things you start to learn on the piano, like Hanon, and they're all for the five fingers. And there's works by Debussy and so on, which are come from this concept of just using the five fingers of, well, either one hand or both hands, in a very limited and specific way. And I suppose this drew on my respect for Roger's teaching and so on. So this is kind of a portrait of that side of him. I should also say we thought it would be good, well, I'm very happy that Colleen is happy to learn the work for this world premiere performance here. This work fits the space so well because Roger used to play various different, he was a fabulous pianist. There's various recordings you can dig up or find on YouTube, I'm sure. And in fact, one of the first things I heard of him was a recording of Stockhausen's Sternklang when I was very young, when I was about 14, 15 years old. I saw Roger Smalley playing Hammond organ. So he had this, he didn't just play normal pianos in concert halls. He used different types of keyboards. And my work can be either played on a normal concert grand piano, or some of it can, and the third movement on an upright piano, which can be wheeled into a big hall. So it gives this very intimate, domestic type of aspect of music making. And the final study, which would come after this, can be played on a celeste, because it's all up in the upper part of the piano. Anyhow, this work, as you will hear, is quite simple, and I think works equally well on a big concert grand or on a upright piano like this. So, as I said before, Colleen Lee is going to join us for this performance of For the Five Fingers.
Thank you.
And now we move on to a work by Roger Smalley himself, his suite for two violins. He finished it over a couple of years. For this, I'll be joined with Nam, and actually we played it a couple of times already in Hong Kong, and I think once in Portugal even. Yeah. And it's a fabulous work. For the last 15, 20 years of Roger's life, he wrote a lot of chamber works. There's a fantastic second string quartet, there's a piano quintet, there's a horn trio and so on. Quite large, meaty, weighty works and really substantial works for these chamber music combinations. This is a work which I premiered, which it was written for me, and it's a bit lighter. It's maybe 10 or 11 minutes, and it's in five shortish movements. That's why it's called a suite. Each movement just a couple of minutes. So it begins with a canonic prelude. It's almost like a building. You'll see the little, it's like a building site is actually what Roger used to say about it, or like little Lego building blocks slowly coming together in a kind of a hidden canon. And then there's a moto perpetuo, a very quick flowing movement. Then there's a canto, which is a song-like movement. And then a tango, which uses the first chord of the famous Bach chaconne. But he kind of transforms it quite miraculously into a tango. And then there's a jig to finish. So this is a suite for two violins by Roger Smalley.